我哋把握时间就系、
Let's make the best use of our time. We need to conclude at 1 p.m.
Hi, can,
yes, Gary, Chairman. Chapter 1, we covered the major part of evidence taking last time. I think this time we would concentrate on the data of terminal treatment and also the information papers given to us by the government as a response.If you remember, when I drew an initial conclusion last time, I mentioned we could follow up on Chapter 1 by taking two directions. And number one, the data about MSW, whether it is the production or reuse or recycling aspects, I think they did not have accurate data. And secondly, we said...that in terms of reuse and recycling of MSW, the administration has been moving very slowly with its policies. Last time, we spent quite some time on the data, and we asked the administration to make clarifications. This time around, I'd like to follow up on the slow making of policies. I'd like to thank the administration for giving us a clear response after the last...meeting, and that is Gen 5.
即係做一個咁詳細嘅答覆，但係睇完 Gen 5嗰啲
，I thank them for
更加嬲就仲
this very detailed reply. But after reading it, I'm even more angry. I think the administration is even more unwilling to make policies on MSW. Why do I say that? Please.Read page 11 of the Chinese version. The secretary answered us to say why the per capita production is higher than that in Tokyo, Taipei, and Seoul. Well, the secretary has already said that our GDP has gone up higher, and that is why we are producing more waste. But I'd like to tell you that this is not accurate, as we could see about Seoul.In the last 10-odd years, the GDP of Seoul also rose markedly. Why is it that their per capita waste production has fallen? The secretary said because of cultural differences and other differences, the production level is not the same. I remember 2 years ago, we went to Seoul to look at waste management, and we were given a shock. How did they...take care of the food waste. In 2011, all the food waste in the city was put onto a vessel, and the vessel went into open sea, and it was dumped into the open sea. And then in 2011, they made laws to protect the ocean. And then they said the food waste will not be dumped like that. Well, they have been doing that for decades, and it's their culture. Why were they able to change overnight?So, Secretary, is it really just about a cultural difference? I think there is something that the Secretary dare not say, and that is people have laws. But in Hong Kong, we only have policies, not laws. Therefore, if everything is blamed on geography and culture, that only goes to show that you are not determined.Because you refer to geological, social, economic, and cultural circumstances. You also talk about publicity education policies, but then you will never be able to meet your target. So, Secretary, can you not respond here with regard to your policy outline and the waste reduction blueprint, apart from...mentioning policy targets, what can you do instead of just a carrot? Where is your stick so you can achieve your targets? Chairman, thank you for that question. In the response tabled, we have said that there are different causes for a difference in the volume of waste produced. This has to do with GDP, but that's not the only thing. In Taipei and Seoul, they are cities with an early volume-based charging scheme. In fact, they are the first in Asia, even in the world. And after that, the volume produced changed in a marked fashion. And we are going in that same direction. We have a multi-pronged approach. We would make the policy. There will be a volume-based policy or charging scheme, so people are more aware and they will change their behavior. I wouldn't agree with Mr. Chan. In fact, we have clear policies with clear targets. We have a multi-pronged approach. It's just that some policies require time to be implemented. And I said many times that I hope we can table the charging scheme for scrutiny by LegCo. Well, you talk about the charging scheme, but you have always talked about it since your assumption of office. But coming back in the last term of government, it was said that many things would be done. Car tires, beverage glass bottles, and also waste electronic and electrical products and charging batteries, etc. But last time he said he would not go for batteries, packaging materials, and also car tires. Last time at the meeting, your deputy suddenly told us that these were not urgent items and we would only go for the urgent items first, namely plastic bottles. So is there any continuity in your policy, or it depends who is in the post? You talked about six things and then you tackled three of them. And what about the other three? Are you not confident? Do you not have the will? Or would you just brush aside what was proposed by the last term of government? Is it that you think plastic bottles are the issue, so you just go for it? The thing is, after adjusting your policies, you have not reported that to the council or stakeholders in society. Why? Secretary, maybe my colleague can add in a moment. I think we are all clear since Mr. Chan is an important member of the EA panel. We wrote out the blueprint. It was an important opportunity for us to report progress and also for us to re-examine our policies and assign priorities. So there was a process, but that might not be just a process to review the past. However, our blueprint has indeed been based on experience and how we can look forward and propose new policies and also reprioritize old targets. I think that was the process. When the blueprint was launched, it was discussed in the council and society also had the chance to discuss it. In this term of government, we are writing legislation, the producer responsibility scheme for glass beverage bottle producers and also to tackle waste electrical and electronic products. There are many different initiatives, but we need to prioritize our work. Our blueprint has been set according to that mindset. I think you all agree that looking at overseas experience, volume-based charging is something we should focus on. Green groups and academics also agree that we should go for it. And of course, if there is capacity, we can still attend to other points in the blueprint. Mr. Chan.
Well, today, you also need, you have also had to inherit previous goals. Now, in your blueprint, you might have some producer pay policies that needs to implement, and some have not been continued. Do you think that you have fulfilled your responsibility? Are you not accountable to previous pledges? So how can we be confident that 10 years from now that you will be on target? Or is it that we will always be surrounded by trash? Well, the blueprint has clear goals. We want to work together and have some clear and simple goals, that is to reduce the per capita landfill by 40%. There are different ways and tools to help us achieve the target. In our experience, just having a blueprint doesn't mean it's set in stone. We have to adapt to changes in society. There are priorities. So we need to focus on the overall goal, the major policy, and some targets can be adjusted. So how do we deal with the producer pay principle? So that will be based on our previous experience, and we can have the director elaborate. Well, I think members are concerned that in 2005 the policy guideline listed some suggested producer pay principles, and these are our working targets now. We have not, aside from the three, the plastic bag producer principle, the discarded electrical appliance, and glass bottle principle, the other three producer pay principles after we review the three producer pay principles, the remaining three items, we will, if we were to introduce increase the producer pay principle, we'll look at we'll have to assess our landfill situation, and we will report back to the EA panel. Currently, our priorities are the two producer pay principles that we've tabled in front of LegCo, and our priority will be on municipal solid waste levy by volume, because the latter involves different stakeholders, and the resources and time required, the bill submitted will be very complex. For the remaining three, we will review, and if we come up with a conclusion or preliminary view, we will report back to the council. Well, I think this is a reasonable response. The secretary did not shove the responsibility to LegCo for following up the remaining three producer pay principles. Now, we should now look at the MSW that is dumped at landfills. In other words, we need to handle the simpler jobs first. Well, does that mean that you don't need targets? Because 10 years hence, the next secretary will ignore it. So that is not a responsible attitude. This will also affect the civil servants working under you, because they are just following your orders. And if you say all of a sudden we need to achieve these targets, but then 10 years from now they will be questioned by the PAC, by the council, and that's not fair to them. So I think I have drawn my conclusions from questions addressed to the witness. Well, The main reason for the second round of inquiry into Chapter 1, I think Chairman understands that in the first round, we had Ms. Christine Low, the Acting Secretary. I had pointed out to the Acting Secretary that after the Audit Commission's report, we see that you have overestimated the recycling rate of MSW. There is a lack of statistics to indicate how much material deposited in landfill can be recycled. And they also underestimated the life cycle of the landfills. So, given more accurate statistics, can they come up with a new estimate? Well, I think the witness in the verbatim minutes R65/1 in VER1. We do not give them a verbatim minute. I'll just read out the important parts. In the verbatim record, page 38, I had this question. I said, at the time, I was engaged in a dialogue with Ms. Christine Low. I had said, let me put it this way. I'd like to ask the Acting Secretary if the funding applications for incinerators and landfills, as an example, based on statistics you submit to LegCo, the question was, after the audit, we have lost our confidence. Does the government have a necessary to need to do a re-audit to come up with a better estimate? And they also need to report to LegCo the need for a landfill? Ms. Christine Low had responded, I quote, the audit report has some shortfalls. If we examine from today onwards whether Hong Kong needs to build extra landfills and other treatment facilities, then when should these be completed? This is totally irrelevant. I feel that a timetable can be revised because some areas have fallen behind schedule, but overall speaking, even if we come for funding, we would like you to endorse some of the legislation. I think that there are no problems with the direction taken. And then Chairman made the very wise comment, and I quote, Secretary, Mr. Leung's question is very clear. If you look at the statistics, if they have been exaggerated, we've already funded, given you resources. You were also a legislative counselor. You know that we have faith in the government figures. But after reading this report, we feel that we have, well, we don't want to say we have been fooled, but could the resources be used to build a school, a hospital? Resources are not infinite. In this respect, will you review your work? We gave you resources. So in this respect, we need to look forward. What will you do in the future? You've seen the mistakes committed in the past. What will you do in the future? The resources we have allocated, have you still exaggerated your case? And then there's other dialogue, and I don't want to repeat that. So in page 46 of the verbatim record, that records the response. The chairman and acting secretary have a dialogue. They said, well, respond a bit later, that's fair. We have raised such a big question. You've asked them to reassess and so on. I don't want you to have, I don't want there to be no room for you to maneuver. So acting secretary said that in this respect, we can definitely provide an update. So I'm waiting in in eager anticipation. So, Chairman would recall in Chapter 1, there's a Table 2. We have import, export, the recycled material. Some 2 million tons were missing. So based on these figures, they came to LegCo for funding for 3 landfills and 1 incinerator. And yesterday, I met with a PAC secretary and I said, is this all the material we have? The secretary said that that's all we have. What kind of material? It's Gen 5. Gen 5, Chairman. Mr. Tanhakan had quoted this material after the last meeting. So the relevant response is that is W and X on page 3940 of the Chinese version. So I am disappointed with this response. The government is irresponsible and they have not reviewed their past. They give us the impression that they have pulled the wool over our eyes. They're using inaccurate figures. So the 3 landfill and 1 incinerator, you've paid the bill and that's it. How do they respond? Well, it's a very short response. We asked the secretary, had excerpted my response from the verbatim record, and will the government amend the MSW strategy and planning, reduce the transport, recycling, manufacture, MSW? If so, please provide detailed information. If not, please give a reason. So the response is no, because the reply, according to the 2013 blueprint, we have set out comprehensive strategies to achieve the single target, and it seems that the response is that the audit indicates that the statistics for the funding application for the 3 landfill and 1 incinerator was wrong. So in order to have a more efficient use of the resources, that way we could build hospitals, we could build schools. So I'd like to give the secretary an opportunity to answer. How come you can be so irresponsible? Especially on the last occasion, the acting secretary said very clearly that they would come up with an update, and I'm using her words. There would be an update. So now we don't have an update. So, is this the attitude of a responsible government? When the department responded, we had looked at the question. So there are 2 parts to this question. I won't repeat. We had just responded to the wording of the question. So that was the process. But members are concerned that in the previous dialogue, the expectation or understanding was that there should be an update. I think that's where the difference is. If you're referring to the written response, we had replied in writing in a way we thought appropriate. Well, the acting secretary had made a pledge, so are we still waiting for this document? When will it be submitted? Well, if there is a relevant question, let me put it this way. We will quote the verbatim record and you can provide a written response, because you had promised us that. We asked the question. Well, you were in France at the time, and now we'll give you more time to consider. We don't have a lot of time, but we can still wait for your report, your response. So in question X, you have not, you weren't, your response to question X is not adequate. We know the, we understand what the question is, we will try our best to answer. Just answer our question, okay? Well, I'd like to point out to the secretary that in the last inquiry, we had stated why we want a reassessment. Because as I read the question to the secretary, this limited public resources cannot, we cannot invest them inappropriately based on inaccurate information. I think the secretary understands. When we talked about the three landfill and one incinerator, the finance committee were very concerned that you can call it the upstream, midstream, downstream. We need to reduce MSW at the upstream. We need to increase the recycling. And at the downstream, we only have a landfill and incineration. At the time, the FC members, especially those who objected, they had put forward the argument that it is of concern that there would be unnecessary capacity in the landfill and incinerator, and you would not expend as much effort in the upstream processes. So aside from what I pointed out, and as our chairman also said, that the deployment of resources, can it be more efficient if you expand landfills or if you build incinerators, couldn't there be a better option? And we have now, we're now in our third round of the inquiry. We are very concerned. I respect the secretary and the undersecretary. I'm concerned that your blueprint cannot be accomplished. So whether it is deployment of resources, did you make wrong assumptions, and will you continue to make the mistakes based on this false information or inaccurate information, or should we, after some revision, should we increase the incentives in the upstream, midstream, and downstream, because this reassessment is important. And I believe that, personally speaking, before we write our report, if the department and bureau of continue to avoid our question, you can anticipate that at least I personally will come to a very harsh conclusion. I would like the secretary to understand that. I don't think you can answer us today right now, but there is an importance to this document. Thank you. Well, I think members can expect that we will follow up with your written question, but I just want to... No, that's not the point. There is a timetable for your blueprint, and there is a big problem with your blueprint, as pointed out by the audit report. So shouldn't you have a timetable for revising your blueprint? Because this involves resources, and this affects the audit report and our value for money assessment. You have to look at it from a macro perspective. How are you going to resolve this issue, and so on?
I've already asked the question. If you don't give us an answer, we'll look at it from a macro perspective. Chairman, I'd like to make two points. First of all, members are concerned about the figures, the recycling figures. And I think if you look at the paper, you'll find that the EPD has pointed out the deficiencies in the figures, and we proactively engaged consultant to review the figures. That was before we applied for the three landfills and incinerators. So this has nothing to do with the issue of the three incinerators and one, the three landfills and one incinerator. So I don't think we've misled members in reaching your, making your decision. Secretary, could you look go back to those documents? Mr. Leung has referred to them already. The papers read by the PwC and the FC has already highlighted the inadequacies and mistakes on your part. Perhaps you can go back and take a look at those papers again. You can't say that this is different from the situation in the past. No, that's not what I mean. I was just referring to the chronology. We'll certainly give members a paper to give an explanation. And to answer members' questions, I think the direction in the blueprint is very clear. We are not actually relaxing our efforts. We are basically following the timetable of that blueprint, and we aim to implement them, you know, in a step-by-step manner. I think if you give an answer like that, it's difficult for us to write our report. We need to make a decision. So please show us all the papers. And also, could you read all those papers? In your blueprint, there is a timetable explaining how you plan to achieve your targets. Please go back to the part regarding the three landfills and the incinerators. Please, you know, conduct a review. Don't just tell us that there is a timetable. There are some inconsistencies there. Could you go back and look at it? Don't give us an answer like the one that you gave us just now. Otherwise, we will have to make a decision or draw a conclusion. Any further questions, Kenneth? No? If not, thank you very much. Thank you.